Hey, pop shoppers, welcome to Ed Rambeau's little corner of the world.
You to me are sweet as roses in the morning. You to me are soft as summer rain at dawn, and love we share, that's something rare. The sidewalks in the street, the concrete and the clay beneath my feet begins to crumble, but love will never die.
Good evening, everyone. This is Ed Rambeau, and for the next half hour, you'll be joining me in my little corner of the world. But before announcing what tonight's theme is, this past Wednesday, July 8th, my faithful listener and very dear friend, Ronnie Allen, celebrated a birthday. Ronnie is usually in the chat room, so let's all shout out a nice, big, happy, belated birthday to Ronnie Allen. Happy birthday, Ronnie. Hope it was a good one and better than mine, because I spent my entire birthday in bed with an horrendous cough and cold sweats. So I'm sure you can all hear slight remnants of whatever I had in my voice because it's still lingering. I just can't seem to shake this nasty bug. I don't feel bad, just have an occasional cough and this froggy-sounding voice. So I ask that you please all bear with me. Anyway, again, happy belated birthday, Ronnie Allen. Now for tonight's theme. I decided to return to the music of Broadway. Therefore, tonight's show is simply named Broadway Revisited. And to start off the show, here's a rousing number from the celebrated Ethel Merman classic, Gypsy. It's called Some People.
Some people can get a thrill knitting sweaters and sitting still. That's okay for some people who don't know they're alive. Some people can thrive and bloom, living life in a living room. That's perfect for some people of 105. But I at least gotta try. When I think of all the sights that I gotta see, yet all the places I gotta play, all the things that I gotta be at, come on, Papa, what do you say? Some people can be content playing bingo and paying rent. That's peachy for some people, for some humdrum people to be. But some people ain't me. I had a dream, a wonderful dream, Papa. All about June in the Orpheum Circuit. Give me a chance and I know I can work it. Oh, what a dream. Just as real as can be, Papa. There I was in Mr. Orpheum's office, and he was saying to me, kid, get yourself some new orchestrations, new routines and red velvet curtains. Get a feathered hat for the baby, photographs in front of the theater. Get an agent, and in jig time you'll be being booked in the big time. Oh, what a dream, a wonderful dream, Papa. And all that I need is 88 bucks, Papa. That's what he said, Papa. Only 88 bucks. Goodbye to blueberry pie. Good riddance to all the socials I had to go to, all the lodgers I had to play, all the Shriners I said hello to. Hey, LA, I'm coming your way. Some people sit on their butts, got the dream, yeah, but not the guts. That's living for some people, for some humdrum people, I suppose. Well, they can stay and rot. But not Rambeau.
Some people, introduced by the great Ethel Merman from the Broadway show Gypsy. Turning now to a song from a musical initially created and written by Mari Yeston as a class project in Lehman Engel's BMI Music Theater Workshop in 1973. It was later developed with a book by Mario Frati, and then again with a book by Arthur Copit, music and lyrics by Mari Yeston. The story is based on Federico Fellini's semi-autobiographical film, Eight and a Half. It focuses on film director Guido Contini, who is dreading his imminent 40th birthday and facing a midlife crisis, which is blocking his creative impulses and entangling him in a web of romantic difficulties in early 1960s Venice. The show is entitled Nine, and this is one of my personal favorite songs from that show. It's called Unusual Way. In a very unusual way, one time I needed you. In a very unusual way, you were my friend. Maybe it lasted a day, maybe it lasted an hour, but somehow it will never end. In a very unusual way, I think I'm in love with you. In a very unusual way, I want to cry. Something inside me goes weak, something inside me surrenders, and you're the reason why, you're the reason why. What you do to me, you don't have a clue. You can't tell what it's like to be me looking at you. It scares me so that I can hardly speak. In a very unusual way, I owe what I am to you. Though at times it appears I won't stay, I never go. Special to me in my life, since the first day that I met you. How could I ever forget you, once you had touched my soul? That was Unusual Way from Nine, originally sung by Raul Julia. My next selection comes from the renowned Jerome Kern and Oscar Hammerstein II musical, Showboat. This wonderful song contrasts the struggles and hardships of African Americans with the endless, uncaring flow of the Mississippi River. It is sung from the point of view of a black stevedore on a showboat and is the most famous song from the show. Please enjoy my rendition of this amazing song, Old Man River.
The
There's an old man called the Mississippi. That's the old man that I long to. What does he care if the world's got troubles? What does he care if the land ain't free? That old man River, he must know something, but he don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, he keeps on rolling along. He don't plant taters, and he don't plant cotton, and them that plant some are soon forgotten. But old man River, he just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain, body all aching and racked with pain. Tote that barge, lift that bale, get a little drunk, and you'll land in jail. I get weary and sick of trying. I'm tired of living and scared of dying. But old man River, he just keeps rolling
River from Showboat, a classic song from a classic musical. For those of you who may have just tuned in, you're listening to Ed Rambeau with a very froggy voice, and this is My Little Corner of the World on oldiesyourway.com. Tonight's theme, Broadway Revisited. But first, this evening we have a visit from an old friend who hasn't been around for a while. I'm speaking, of course, about America's favorite pussycat, Talking Tom. Come on in and say hello, Tom.
Everybody, it's me again, the highlight of the show.
Now.
By the way, Eduardo, I think I caught your cold. Can you hear it in my voice?
As a matter of fact, I can, Tom.
What are you, blonde? That's because my voice is your voice, you silly dummy.
All right, cut it out. Two short jokes, Tom. What do you got for us?
I got two goodies. But first, I don't know if you're aware of this or not, but I can sing too.
Oh, really? Well, let's hear a little bit then.
Okay, here goes. Everything I have is mine.
Tom, everything I have is yours.
I know that, Eduardo, and I'm glad I'm in the will. But that's neither here nor there. What did you think of my singing?
Not bad, but let's just hear the jokes, okay?
Yeah, okay. A wife was making a breakfast of fried eggs for her husband. Suddenly her husband burst into the kitchen screaming, "Careful! Be careful! Put in some more butter! Oh my God, you're cooking too many at once! Too many! Turn them over! Turn them now! We need more butter! They're gonna stick! You never listen to me when you're cooking! Never! And don't forget to salt them! You know you always forget to salt them! Use the salt! And pepper too! Don't forget the pepper!" The wife stared at him blankly, then said, "What in the world is wrong with you? You think I don't know how to fry a couple of eggs?" The husband calmly replied, "I just wanted to show you what it feels like when I'm driving."
Oh, love that one, Tom. Got another?
Yeah, I do. A middle-aged guy is out to dinner with his wife to celebrate her 40th birthday. He says, "So what would you like, Julie? A Jaguar? A sable coat? A diamond necklace?" She says, "Bernie, I want a divorce." He says, "Oh my, I wasn't planning on spending that much."
Huh, very funny, Tom, but I'm afraid that's all the time there is, so you're going to have to say goodnight, okay?
Good night, everybody. I'm turning the show back over to Eduardo now, so get out your earplugs. Meanwhile, my catnip awaits.
Good night, Tom. See you in 2 weeks. So there you have it, folks, America's favorite pussycat, Talking Tom. Returning now to our theme for tonight, Broadway Revisited, here's my version of the title song from that wonderful John Kander and Fred Ebb musical, Cabaret.
What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play.
The music play.
Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
Come to the cabaret.
Put down the knitting, the book, and the broom. Time for a holiday.
A holiday.
Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
The cabaret.
Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Come blow your horn, start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting. No use permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Come blow your horn, start celebrating.
Right this way, your table's waiting. No use permitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Come taste the wine.
Come taste the wine.
Come hear the band.
Come hear the band.
Come blow your horn, start celebrating. Right this way, your table's waiting. Stop by admitting, from cradle to tomb, it isn't that long a stay. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Only a cabaret, old chum. And I love a cabaret.
That, of course, was Cabaret from Cabaret, a song which has become rather synonymous with the great Liza Minnelli. A wonderful tune recorded by the Swedish pop group ABBA is just one of many songs that went on to make up the score of a Broadway musical entitled Mamma Mia. For me, there were two songs in that show that were highlights, the ever-popular Dancing Queen and the one I'm about to sing for you tonight. Please enjoy my version of The Winner Takes It All.
I don't wanna talk about things we've gone through, though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside the victory. That's his destiny. I was in your arms, thinking I belonged there. I figured it made sense, building me a fence, building me a home, thinking I'd be strong there. But I was a fool, playing by the rules. But gods may throw the dice, their minds as cold as ice. And someone way down here loses someone dear. The winner takes it all, the loser has to fall. It's simple and it's plain, why should I complain? But tell me, does he kiss the way I used to kiss you? Does it feel the same when he calls your name? Somewhere deep inside, you must know I miss you. But what can I say? Rules must be obeyed. The judges will decide, the likes of me abide. Spectators of the show, always staying low. The game is on again, a lover or a friend, a big thing or a small, the winner takes it all. I don't want to talk if it makes you feel sad, and I understand you've come to shake my hand. I apologize if it makes you feel bad, seeing me so tense, no self-confidence. But you see, the winner takes it all.
As if it were yesterday, I can remember sitting in the audience watching a wonderful musical entitled Rent. And there was one particular song in that show that caught my ear as well as my attention. It's a song I've had the great fortune of recording and would like to sing for you tonight. So, from the Broadway show Rent, please enjoy my rendition of an awesome song that is rarely heard, entitled Without You.
Without you, the ground thaws, the rain falls, the grass grows. Without you, the seeds root, the flowers bloom, the children play, the stars gleam, the poets dream, the eagles fly without you. The earth turns, the sun burns, but I die without you.
You just heard Without You from the musical Rent. For my closing number, I wanted to choose one of the many songs I've had the pleasure of recording from the Broadway musical The Boy from Oz, celebrating the rather short life and career of the incomparable Peter Allen. With so many wonderful tunes to choose from, I've selected one of my personal favorites. It's called I'd Rather Leave While I'm in Love.
I'd rather leave while I'm in love, while I still believe the meaning of the word. I keep my dreams and just pretend that you and I were never meant to end. Too many times I've seen a rose die on the vine. Somebody's heart gets broken, usually it's mine. I don't want to take the chance of being hurt again. And you and I can't say goodbye. So if you wake and find me gone, just carry on. You see, I need my fantasy. I still believe it's best to leave while I'm in love. Too many times I've seen a rose die on the vine. Somebody's heart gets broken, usually it's mine. I don't wanna take the chance of being hurt again. And you and I can't say goodbye. So if you wake and find me gone, just carry on. You see, I need my fantasy. I still believe it's best to leave while I'm in love. Oh, I still believe it's best to leave while I'm in love.
And on that rousing note, that about wraps it up, my friends. However, since this show was about Broadway musicals, it brings to mind a very humorous story with regard to my dad. The day I signed my first recording contract with Swan Records, my dad drove both me and my manager, Bud Rehak, to Philadelphia. After the contract was signed, before driving back home, we decided to grab a bite to eat. Afterwards, we came upon a movie theater which was premiering the film West Side Story. Both Bud and I had been waiting with bated breath for this film to open in theaters, so we dragged my dad inside to see the movie. Afterwards, I said to my father, "So what did you think of the movie, Dad?" His reply was short, "Eh, too much singing." That's my dad for you. Anyway, with that being said, this is Ed Rambeau, and from my little corner of the world to yours, here's thanking you all for being here and wishing each and every one of you a very pleasant good night. Now please stay tuned for more of Stu Weiss and his wonderful pop shop. Good night with buckets of love, everyone. Here's Stu Weiss and his wonderful pop shop on oldiesyourway.com.